Tripura Asura Samhar. King Parikshit inquired, "O sage, I hear that the supreme Brahman re-established the glory of Lord Shiva, which was tarnished by the magic achievements of the demon Maya. How was it possible for a demon to lower the fame of Lord Shiva? And how did the supreme restore it? Please narrate the same, thirsty as I am to know such great secrets." Here it would be useful to understand Indra as the mind, Brihaspati as self-knowledge, Vishwarupa as material knowledge, Vritra as animal knowledge, Chitraketu as Jiva, Shiva and Uma as Purusha and his power, Vajra or thunderbolt is the sword of detachment or renunciation. The sage replied, Shuka replied, "After the gods had tasted the nectar got by churning the ocean of milk, a great battle took place between the gods and the demons. The demons were all defeated and destroyed, but some ran away and escaped death. They sought the protection of the demon called Maya, who was an expert in witchcraft. He was a great engineer and was capable of creating devices which the gods could not know. He was the engineer who built the famous palace for the Pandavas at Indraprastha. He planned out very secretly and created three magic flying cities of gold, silver, and steel. The cities could move about without being noticed by others. Nobody could know what the cities were made up of, how the cities move, how one goes and the other comes on. They were unperceivable by others. Each city was furnished with numerous articles of utility, usefulness, and of pleasure. He handed over those cities to the demon chiefs. The demons utilized them as they pleased. They had their grudge against the gods, and so they began to attack and destroy the gods. The gods, even though they had tasted the nectar, could not bear the cruelties of these demons. They went and beseeched Lord Shiva and prayed for protection. Lord Shiva gave them shelter and asked them not to be afraid. He took his mighty bow, pronounced some mantras, and sent one arrow, which developed into millions of arrows, burning like fire and shining like sun rays, destroyed the three cities. All the inhabitants of the cities lay down dead. Maya, being very cunning, brought those dead bodies and threw them all into a special tank which was full of nectar-like water. As soon as the dead bodies touched that nectar-like water, they regained life and the bodies became as strong as steel. The demons began to attack the gods again. Lord Shiva was disappointed and downcast. His attempts failed. His power became useless. The Supreme Lord Vishnu observed the predicament of Lord Shiva and wanted to rectify matters. He took the form of a beautiful and attractive cow. He converted Brahma as his calf, and with the calf he slowly strayed here and there and at midnight entered the three cities. He went to the tank containing the nectar-like water and slowly drank off the whole lot and made the tank dry. All the demons and the special guards watching the tank were looking on and admiring the cow and totally forgot to prevent the cow from touching the water. Maya came to know about this development and declared, addressing the demons, "Why should we feel sorry? What is ordained by the Brahman cannot be interrupted or altered by anybody, either the mortal man, the divine god, or the cunning demon. One cannot escape the judgment of the Lord or alter the destiny of another. Thy will be done is the only law, the irrevocable law." Then the Supreme Lord created out of his power of righteousness, wisdom, renunciation, prosperity, tapas, learning and activities for Lord Shiva, which he used them as chariot, driver, flag, horses, bow, armor, and arrows. Lord Shiva received them, put on the armor, got into the chariot, took the bow, pronounced some mantras and sent the arrows on the three flying cities in the bright sunlight of the midday, Abhijit Lagna. The unperceivable three cities were burnt away. All the gods and celestials began to praise Lord Shiva for his achievement, and he was thereafter called Tripurari, the destroyer of the three cities. Thus, the Supreme, who has the capacity to deceive the deceivers, performed great exploits which are very difficult even for great sages to recount. What wonder if this appears so strange? Tripura means the three cities, that is, bodies wherein the Supreme dwells and gives them the semblance of life, without whom they would revert to be mere dust. The term is used as an allegory. There are great expositions on this subject. Here in this context, it may be taken as Ishvara to be the seeker, the Jiva, Vishnu the Supreme Lord or the Self, Asuras or the demons who are no other than the evil thoughts and evil tendencies in the seeker, the gods or the noble thoughts and noble intentions. Even though the seeker tries to curb the evil thoughts as often as he can, their vasanas linger in the seeker's bosom and they sprout up again and again as though they have drunk nectar and overwhelm his good intentions. For this, a total surrender to the Self, the Supreme, is the only remedy. His grace helps him in the shape of the beautiful cow and drinks away the vasana, revival, the nectarian water and dries up. The vasanas no more raise their heads. The three cities are the gross, subtle and causal bodies. Gold, silver and steel are the three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. The evil thoughts travel through all these states, namely waking, dream and deep sleep. They can be got rid of slowly with the aid of righteousness, learning, wisdom, action, prosperity, renunciation and tapas, and obtaining the grace of the Supreme. These evils can be destroyed by the seeker in the midday, meaning in the light of true knowledge.